It's that time of year where we have to be worried about winter weather when we're traveling across Montana. We hope that you'll be ready and be prepared. This is a short presentation by the Montana Department of Transportation, Ready Montana, the American Red Cross, and the National Weather Service. If you do have to travel in the wintertime, we ask that you check the forecast and the road conditions. I can't tell you how many times we've had people that have only done one, not the other, and then 4 hours into their trip find out things are way worse than they expected as the weather has moved in and made the roads pretty bad. File a flight plan. Tell somebody where you're going, when you expect to get there, and what way you're traveling to do that. And once you're there, let them know that you've arrived. That way they're not worried and looking for you. And convoy, a lot of basketball tournaments and wrestling meets and hockey games. A lot of people traveling for these types of things. So if you can go with other families, it's a good thing. If something happens, there's someone else there to help you. Also, leave earlier than you normally would. You know, if it's a short trip, 10 to 15 minutes should be good. If you're traveling partway across the state or all the way across the state, consider leaving 1 to 2 hours earlier than you normally would, just to make sure you get there in the time you need to. And if the road reports are showing things are really, really bad, like on this map on the right, and there's blizzard warnings and major winter storm warnings out across the state, it might just be best to stay home. To get the weather forecast, we recommend you go to weather.gov. This is the National Weather Service website, and you can get a forecast anywhere around the country by clicking on this map or putting your city and state into the little box on the left side. In this example, we're going to go to the Missoula National Weather Service office by clicking in Western Montana. And we can see the page here. The page is full of information from the forecast, which you can get by clicking on the map there and finding the location you want, and radar data, observation data, all kinds of information. One of the ones that might be most overlooked, but maybe most helpful to you traveling, though, is the travel page. This tab is on all the Weather Service offices pages here in Montana. Here's what the page looks like. You can see a lot of colors on here. If you were to move your mouse over one of the segments of highway, it will tell you what kind of weather event is causing this in the future. So this is a forecast, not the actual conditions observed. So in this instance, it might be heavy snow, it might be fog, it could be very high winds, a variety of things. So clicking on it will show you what the weather phenomena is. Now, if you go to the very bottom, you can see that there's every 6 hours a forecast out to 36 hours. This will help you decide if you need to make an alternate route and go a different way than you normally would travel to get somewhere. When traveling in the winter, a few things that we recommend. Number one is wearing your seat belt. About 20 to 25% of Montanans do not wear their seat belts. Yet, of all the fatal vehicle accidents in the state, 70% of those were people who did not have their seat belts on. The next thing is keeping your gas tank full in the winter. I hope that's pretty obvious to most people, but if you could at least keep it above half a tank when traveling, that would be helpful for you. And fill it up on the nicer days. If you know there's a big storm coming in or a cold front coming in tomorrow, go and fill it up today before you're having to stand out there with temperatures 20, 30, 40 degrees colder than it had been. Take better traveled roads. There's more chances for help if something does happen. Keep distance between your vehicle and others. There's always going to be somebody that seems to want to tailgate and get around you. If that's the case and the roads are icy and snowy, just pull over and let them around. One thing people don't normally think about is keeping your jacket on while you're traveling, maybe even your gloves. If there were to be an accident, we would certainly hope that never happens, but if the vehicle flips or somebody is thrown out or glass breaks, your jacket will keep you from becoming hypothermic before help ever arrives. It's a very, very small chance that this is going to happen, but if it were, it's something you probably would appreciate, is having that jacket on. Another thing, do not use cruise control on snowy and icy roads. Unless they are absolutely dry, cruise control is going to be more of a detriment than a help to you when it comes to dealing with snow and black ice. And lastly, I thankfully had parents who allowed me to practice skidding out as a teenager. They took me to lakes. You could do parking lots late at night, but learn how to skid. Know to steer into the skid and what to do with your brakes so that when you actually do have it occur out of the blue, you're familiar with what to do. How about you ignored that stay home rule and now you're stuck out there on the road somewhere? Well, stay with your vehicle. Don't try and leave it to get help. Try to make a phone call for help, 911. Generally, your phone will increase the signal so that you can get to 911, or text message somebody if possible. Run the engine 10 minutes every hour and make sure you leave your window open just a little bit. Do some exercises to stay warm. Move your legs, move your arms, but do not work up a sweat. You don't want to have any water on your body because that can help cause you to become hypothermic quicker. If you need a shovel and you don't already have one in your winter survival kit, hubcaps or a sun visor might work to help shovel you out if need be. You could also burn engine oil in a hubcap if needed, but only going to really help in the daytime where people can see the smoke. And there is a standard distress signal that you can use, and that's 3 long blasts of your car horn 10 seconds apart and repeating that every 30 seconds. If you're in an area where you think there might be a home or somebody nearby that can hear it, you might want to try that, but there's a lot of places in Montana where nobody may hear that for a very long time until other vehicles start moving again. Another thing to consider is ice and snow, take it slow. Do not crowd that snow plow. These folks in Montana are pretty darn good when they see cars starting to pile up behind them. They'll pull over and let you around. But give them some room. They can't always see you even though you're seeing them. They also have snow clouds from the big amount of snow that's being pushed away. So again, be extremely cautious behind a snow plow. Give them the room they need to do the work that they are doing, and they will eventually let you around if it's not safe to pass otherwise. Areas where you accelerate or decelerate, such as getting on and off the interstate. Other areas, low traffic roads, such as back gravel roads or even the back country roads that aren't so well traveled, could be trouble spots because there's not enough tires causing friction, causing the ice to melt. Another area is in tunnels and mountainous regions. Because of the weather conditions in mountains, things can vary drastically in a short distance. The top of a hill might be actually dry and no problems, but a half mile down towards the bottom where the cold air sinks, you could have quite a bit of ice at the bottom. So again, those are some of the hot spots to watch out for when traveling. If you need additional resources, you can visit the Weather Service offices in Montana, the Montana Department of Transportation on their safety page, the American Red Cross, and Ready Montana. We hope that you have a safe winter.